What are the different lifetime scopes of the services created from ASP.NET Core dependency injection? The three different lifetime scopes are transient, scope, singleton. Let's discuss each lifetime in more details. To understand transient lifetime scope, let's consider a system, order processing system, which is taking multiple orders. Order 1 is received. So once order 1 is received, it is checked against inventory whether we have enough inventory to process the order. If it is valid, process the order. So this is order 1 is a one request in the system, and there's another request for order 2. Same steps repeat: receive the order, check inventory, if inventory is good, process order. And suppose we are logging each step. Order 1, request 1 has 3 steps and each step is being logged. So when we use transient lifetime, the ASP.NET Core gives new object or new service or new object for every entry. So behind the scenes, if we are creating a log from the container, it is doing new log for each request. So order 1 created 3 services or objects behind the scene, and order 2 same way created three services. So 2 order created 6 services. If there was order 1 more, we'll have 3 more. So every step of the request is creating a new service or object behind the scene. Now let's see what is the scoped one. Let's go draw the same system. We receive the order, check the inventory, we process the order, and we are getting 2 orders. In this system we have 2 requests, order 1 request and order 2 request. So what happens if we logging each steps? When it is scoped, then per request one instance of the service or object is created per request. So order 1 has created one service or one object behind the scene, whereas same way order 2 has created one object or one service behind the scene. So per request one object is being created in the scoped. So we saw in transient we had 6 in for 2 requests. In scoped we have 2 objects per 2 requests. If we had one more request in scoped, there will be 3 services or instances of objects. So let's see the singleton. Same singleton, we are receiving 2 orders, we are checking the inventory, process the order. In singleton what happens, all the log service requests goes to single instance of the service or single instance of the object. So in this case we will have only one instance of the service which is processing all the objects. So if this is a pattern, if you need a singleton pattern, this is very good way to do. So if you summary singleton 1-1. If you like the video, like it, share it and subscribe to this channel for your regular updates. Thanks for watching.